Rishi, the way you started from the state of the pure soul to experiencing the state of absolute knowledge, what spiritual effort of yours was there between the two? Was it following the agnas? Was it breaking the karmic tubas?
There are two things which come to mind, actually three things. One was, conversation with Deepak was happening. That was very beneficial. Every time, as I kept separating myself from the one who was speaking, I was able to reach all the way to the original self. Second, the spiritual effort to check where the five agnas were missed was always going on. Third was to see others as faultless, to see everyone as faultless, no matter what. Whether someone hit me, looted me, cheated me, did something bad to me, or seriously accused me. But by always checking how he is faultless, a very significant understanding started to unveil for me. This happened in 1977. Back then, I had had a job for 4 years, and then I ran a business for 15 to 17 years. So the worldly dealings of money and all were there. So I would go and come back, but one corner of my being was always separate. It was as if the pudgal or non-self complex kept doing the worldly interactions without me being connected to it. The karma would unfold according to Vyavasthit, and Deepak would come and go, take on the work, finish the work, collect the money, create the bills, but I was disconnected from that doer. I didn't have control over him, and as a matter of fact, I couldn't do it either. The karma was emptying out as it unfolded. From that day, I understood that I had become separate from him. A lot had come into my experience.
કે આ આત્મા આ જે દેખાય છે તે આત્મા, કે આ જાગૃતિને જે જોઈ રહ્યું છે તે આત્મા છે, આમાં પોતે શું કરી રહ્યો છે એમાં જ્ઞાન આત્મા એનો જાણનારો છે, એવું પાછું ઊભું રહે. દાદાનું વાક્ય નીકળેલું, અવસ્થાને જે જાણે છે તે આત્માની જ્ઞાન શક્તિ છે. ત્યારથી પાછું પોતે અવસ્થાઓને વાંચનારો અને પછી એનાથી પણ આગળ શુદ્ધાત્મા રહેલો છે, જે તત્વ સ્વરૂપે એબ્સોલ્યુટ જે કઈ
જેટલા પ્રદેશો છે એટલા બધા જ્ઞેય છે. અનંતા પ્રદેશો છે, અનંતા જ્ઞેય છે. અનંતા પ્રદેશ અનંતા જ્ઞેયને જાળવામાં
પરિણમેલી અનંતી અવસ્થાઓમાં હું સંપૂર્ણ શુદ્ધ છું, સર્વાંગ
શુદ્ધ છું. એ ઠેઠ વાક્ય છે, સંપૂર્ણ વાક્ય છે. એ વાક્ય યાદ ના રહે તને?
એ વધારે ઉપયોગ મારે, એ વધારે ઉપયોગ મારે.
Every single property of the self has gotten set by applying at least 25 examples. Dada says, to bring the concepts of the real into the relative, and that too using examples, the concepts of the real, to be able to convey from which viewpoint they are being discussed, that can be done only if the Siddhant has become unveiled. So I realized, this is what is happening to me. The connection from the past, the unveiled vision of the Siddhant, that concept can fit into understanding through many examples. And that is a result of the devout study done in the past life.
Pujishri, the Jagruti that came into your experience in 1977, thereafter, did you feel that you were able to progress in the stages of experience? What stages came in that process?
Some flashes would keep coming. I understood that I am separate. The separation would prevail from within. Then I came across a really nice statement, talks about Keval Nyan Swarup, that the self, the Keval Nyan Swarup, is separate from the Prakriti. It is an illuminator. All of that kept on increasing.
લાગણીઓ ઉત્પન્ન થાય ત્યાં આત્મા રહેલો છે અને આખા દેહમાં કેવળ જ્ઞાન સ્વરૂપે રહેલો છે, અમૂર્ત રહેલો છે. પછી રૂમને જુએ તો રૂમ, આકાશને જુએ તો આકાશ. તો કે એ બધી વસ્તુઓ આમ તરત બધી આખી જાગૃતિ બધું એને જ પકડી લે છે બધું, આત્માનું જે સ્વરૂપ છે. પછી એ પ્રમાણે આખો દિવસ એ ઉપયોગમાં રાખ્યા કરે કે આ આ આ પછી બધી આની સાથે કમ્પેર કરીને પહેલાંને પેલો જવાબ મૂકે કેવળ જ્ઞાન સ્વરૂપ આ વ્યવહાર થયો છે અને વચ્ચે એનું સોલ્યુશન લાવે એવી રીતે બધું. પણ જે આ વસ્તુ જે વસ્તુ પકડી છે કેવળ જ્ઞાન સ્વરૂપને, તો કે એમાં એવું લાગે કે એ વસ્તુ એવી છે ને કે આખું મનની મનની સ્થિતિ પણ આખું વિલય પામી જાય તે વખતે.
બરાબર.
પછી જે અહંકાર પણ શૂન્યતાને પામે છે.
કેવળ જ્ઞાન સ્વરૂપના સોળે સજ્યા શણ ગાત, કેવળ જ્ઞાન સ્વરૂપના સોળે સજ્યા શણ ગાત.
By keeping the કેવળ જ્ઞાન સ્વરૂપ in awareness, all the answers continue to be revealed.
So then, the Keval Gnan Swarup, which you have experienced,
it keeps increasing little by little. The light, the clarity keeps increasing. At first, it would come into awareness once in a month, then once in a day. Now it comes to mind 50 times in a day, and sometimes even 100 to 200 times in a day. It prevails more and more.
Understand that real form, you can see from the perspective of that real form. So what kind of grace or what is at work that you are able to reach that state and look back from there? Otherwise, to reach there and then do this, so what kind of stage is that?
It is certainly a good stage. It is considered a very exalted stage. It can be considered a very exalted state of Jnan, because the developing eye has come into his original form and is then seeing everything. Therefore, it is a tremendous state, a very exalted state. So I feel blissful thinking, what was I before and where has Dada placed me by his grace? And from then, everything, I began to see the reality of the world as it is.
ચાખી જાણી કહી એ દશાના સ્વાદ તો ચાખી જાણી કહી.
સાંભળે એ પણ નમી પડે, સાંભળે એ પણ નમી પડે. આહો આનંદે, આહો આનંદે, મૌન આશીષે પલાળ્યા, મૌન આશીષે પલાળ્યા, મૌન આશીષે પલાળ્યા, મૌન.